Hi dear friends, welcome. Today's topic is Fall Armyworm, Spodoptera frugiparta, and Invasive Alien Species and its Management. I am Professor S. N. Dhrandali from College of Agriculture, Sone. This new invasive pest does have some international common names: alfalfa worm, fall armyworm, southern armyworm, buckworm, budworm, corn budworm, maize budworm, corn leaf worm, cotton leaf worm, daggies, corn worm, grass caterpillar, grass worm, southern grass worm, overflow worm, rice caterpillar, wheat cutworm, and whirl worm. The EPPO code is LAPHFR for Spodoptera frugiparta. You can see male moth of this Spodoptera. The female moth, here you can simply observe that the male and female show some dimorphism. The larvae of fall armyworm, which is on maize plant, and have done remarkable damage to that plant. The taxonomic tree means the arrangement or its classification. Domain is Eukaryota, kingdom Metazoa, phylum Arthropoda, subphylum Uniramia, class Insecta, order Lepidoptera, family Noctuidae, genus Spodoptera, and species Frugiparta. This pest is a potential threat to food security. It is a migratory pest that can fly long distances, up to 100 km per night or 2000 km per lifetime. It is native to the Americas, the tropical regions of Americas, from United States to Argentina and the Caribbean region. In 2017-18, the fall armyworm has damaged crops worth $3.5 to $5 billion, that is 20 to 25% crop yield in the Africas. It is polyphagous, almost 80 recorded host plants in 26 families. The fall armyworm's global spread is given in this animation, where in yellow color you can see the suitable habitat for this pest, which is generally tropical area. Then the blue colored area, it is the native place or native habitat of this fall armyworm, that is the Americas. Third is the recent spread, which is in green color. You can see in 2016 it reached the West Africa, 2017 Southern and East Africa, and at last in 2018 it has been shown that it has reached the Indian subcontinent. We'll stabilize this. You can easily see how the arrangement is, and this pest within 2 years, which entered Africa, reached its second continent, the Asia, and now it has entered other Asian countries including China, which is the second largest maize producing country, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, Myanmar, Thailand, Vietnam, Cambodia. On this map you can see the red spots where the incidence of this larvae of fall armyworm can be seen. This pest has caused a havoc. The map of area affected by fall armyworm, as in March 2019, the Africa's, Indian subcontinent, China, and other Southeastern Asian countries. In India, a pest alert published on July 30th, 2018 by the National Bureau of Agricultural Insect Resources, that is NBIR, confirmed a greater than 70% prevalence of fall armyworm in a maize field in the district of Chikkaballapur, Karnataka. In Maharashtra, fall armyworm was first detected on August 29, 2018 in a maize field at Tandulwadi village in Solapur district. Reports of incidence of fall armyworm are rapidly emerging from several states in India, including Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra and Telangana, Mizoram, Arunachal Pradesh, Odisha, Manipur, Bihar, West Bengal, etc. A live tracking tool for fall armyworm in India has been developed by PEAT, CABI and ICRISAT. The website for this is given. The host plants, a very wide host range with over 80 plants, it prefers grasses. Some evidence of two strains. First is the maize strain or corn strain, and the second is the rice strain. The corn strain infests the corn, also sorghum, cotton, and a few other hosts if they are found growing near the primary host. The rice strain is having its infestation on rice, Bermuda grass, and Johnson's grass. The most frequently consumed plants are field corn and sweet corn, sorghum, alfalfa, barley, buckwheat, cotton, clover, oat, millet, peanut, rice, rye, sugar beet, Sudan grass, soybean, sugarcane, tobacco, and wheat. You can see a bowl of cotton which is damaged heavily by this armyworm. Now, the host plants from horticulture. The apple, grape, orange, papaya, peach, strawberry, and a number of flowers are infested by this pest. The weeds like Bermuda grass, crab grass, bent grass, Johnson's grass, morning glory, nutsedge, pigweed, and sand spur. The identification of fall armyworm can be done with the observation of head, which is having a dark net-like pattern and an upside-down white Y marking. The body, it is having broad pale band along top of the body, contrasted by dark striping at the sides. The 8th abdominal segment with 4 dark spots. The face of the mature larva marked with inverted Y, and epidermis of the larvae is rough or granular in texture when examined closely. However, this larva does not feel rough to the touch as does the corn earworm, Helicorpa Z, because it lacks the microspines found on the similar appearing corn earworm. Here you can observe the 4 dark spots on the abdominal segments. The life cycle of this armyworm is, it is completed in about 30 days during the summer, or 60 days in spring and autumn, or 80 to 90 days during the winter. Females lay eggs in clusters of 50 to a few hundred, up to 2000 eggs in a lifetime. Larval period is usually 14 to 28 days. The ability to diapause is absent. It does have 6 larval instars. 6 to 12 generations per season varies with appearance of dispersing adults. Here is the life cycle of this fall armyworm. Adult female laying the eggs on the leaves or inside the whorls. The egg mass you can see on the leaves. Number of eggs per mass are 100 to 200, and the total egg production per female averages about 1500 with a maximum of over 2000. Sometimes deposited in layers, but most eggs are spread over a single layer attached to foliage. The female also deposits a layer of gray scales, abdominal bristles between the eggs and over the egg mass, imparting a furry or moldy appearance. The duration of egg stage is only 2 to 3 days during the summer months. Dome-shaped eggs, which are flattened at base, the egg curves upward to a broadly rounded point at the apex, 0.4 mm in diameter and 0.3 mm in height. They are green at the time of oviposition and become light brown prior to eclosion, means hatching. The larvae, which are hatched out of the eggs, you can see from the egg mass. Then, these larvae are greenish with a black head, the head turning orangish in the second instar. In the second, but particularly the third instar, the dorsal surface of the body becomes brownish and lateral white lines begin to form. In the fourth to the sixth instar, the head is reddish brown, mottled with white, and the brownish body bears white subdorsal and lateral lines. The elevated spots, also called as black warts, occur dorsally on the body. They are usually dark in color and bear spines. You can see a larva damaging through the maize seeds in the cob. The larval instars, which are 6 in number, the first instar has the head capsule width of 0.35 mm and the larval length of 1.7 mm. Then, second instar, head capsule 0.45 mm, larval length 3.5 mm, Then, third instar, head capsule 0.75 mm, length 6.4 mm, fourth instar 1.3 mm head capsule and 10 mm lateral length, fifth instar 2 mm head capsule width and 17.2 mm length, and the last one, that is sixth instar, is 2.6 mm wide head capsule and the length is 34.2 mm approximately. The mean development time for each instar at 25 degrees Celsius is given. The larvae also show a phenomenon of larval cannibalism. What is actually cannibalism? Eating away or killing its own species for food is cannibalism. You can see on the left hand side that the larva is feeding on its own species and eating it up. Now the pupa. The larva constructs a loose cocoon, oval in shape, and its dimensions are 20 to 30 mm in length by tying together the particles of soil with silk. If the soil is too hard, larvae may web together leaf debris and other material to form a cocoon on the soil surface. The duration of pupal stage is about 8 to 9 days during the summer but reaches 20 to 30 days during the winter. In soil 2 to 8 cm deep, the pupa is reddish brown in color and measures 14 to 18 mm in length and about 4.5 mm in width. You can see the male adult, the female adult that we have earlier discussed about. The forewing generally is shaded gray and brown with triangular white spots at the tip and near the center of the wing. Then the forewings are less distinctly marked in female, ranging from a uniform grayish brown to a fine mottling of gray and brown. The adult's wingspan is 32 to 40 mm. The hind wing is iridescent, silver white, with a narrow dark border in both sexes. The adults are nocturnal, most active during warm, humid evenings. After a pre-oviposition period of 3 to 4 days, they fly for many kilometers before they settle to oviposit. The female normally deposits most of her eggs during the first 4 to 5 days of life, but some oviposition occurs for up to 3 weeks. The duration of adult life is estimated to average about 10 days with a range of about 7 to 21 days. Life cycle of fall armyworm, 35 to 61 days. The adult lays eggs on immature plants, hatching in 3 to 5 days. Then the larvae, which emerge in 14 to 28 days, may tunnel directly into the maize ear. After development, it crawls to the ground to pupate in the soil for 7 to 14 days. Pupation ends and the cycle repeats in warmer climates. The moth lives as an adult for 11 to 14 days. The adult moth blows in on storm fronts, migrating hundreds of kilometers, and the cycle continues. The damage. The young larvae initially consume leaf tissue from one side, leaving the opposite epidermal layer intact. By the second or third instar, larvae begin to make holes in the leaves and eat from the edge of the leaves inwards. Feeding in the whorl of corn often produces a characteristic row of perforations in the leaves. Larval densities are usually reduced to 1 to 2 per plant when larvae feed in close proximity to one another due to cannibalistic behavior, as we have seen earlier. A maize cob damaged very badly by this armyworm. This is the late stage cob. The damage done to the maize crop, you can see phenomena or the symptoms like windowing, skeletonized leaves, the cobs damaged completely, short holes in the leaves, and the damage done to the tassels. Older larvae cause extensive defoliation, often leaving only the ribs and stalks of corn plants or a ragged, torn appearance, acquire an armyworm habit and disperse in large numbers, consuming nearly all vegetation in their path. At high densities, the large larvae or late age larvae may act as armyworms and disperse in swarms, frequently late summer or early autumn, and local dispersal is thus effected successfully, which helps to reduce larval mortality. Management. Most sustainable way to manage it is through an integrated pest management approach, that is IPM. Food and Agriculture Organization has proposed a 5-year program of action to help the smallholder farmers, their organizations, their public institutions, national governments, and development partners to quickly respond to the challenges of fall armyworm infestation. Now, IPM programs. Integrated control of Sporoptera frugiparda through, first, improved varieties with resistance to leaf feeding through conventional mechanisms, or GM crops, that is genetically modified crops. Biological controls are prevalent and should be encouraged through reduced spraying of insecticides. The Centro Internacional de Mejoramiento Maize y Trigo, this is a premier institute of maize and wheat, in 2018 have published a technical guide for IPM of Sporoptera frugiparda in Africa. The cultural techniques to be used. Cultivation practices to destroy overwintering sites through a winter kill by exposing larvae and pupae within the upper soil surface. Freezing temperatures cause high larval mortality, so clean cultivation and weeding is also to be done. Early planting and or early maturing varieties should be used. Early harvest allows many corn ears to escape the higher armyworm densities that develop later in the season. Now, the host plant resistance. Partial resistance is present in some sweet corn varieties, but is inadequate for complete protection. One resistance mechanism that appears to be operating in maize is increased leaf toughness vis-a-vis a thicker epidermis. Transgenic maize containing genes encoding delta endotoxins from Bacillus thuringiensis coxsackii. Vegetative insecticidal proteins, that is VIP, isolated from Bacillus thuringiensis, that is BT, during the vegetative phase of growth, which show a wide spectrum of activities against the Lepidopteran pest, especially Sporoptera species. Sporoptera species appear to be controlled by these toxins, but the development of resistance is a concern. Field-evolved resistance to the BT maize expressing the Cry1AB protein is reducing its efficacy in Brazil. Now, the sampling methods. The moth populations can be sampled with pheromone traps. Pheromone traps should be suspended at canopy height. Once the moths are detected, it is advisable to search for eggs and larvae, and later on they should be managed. Pheromonal control methods. The sex pheromone for Sporoptera frugiparda contains Z9 tetradecenyl acetate, common to Trichoplusiani, Sporoptera exigua, and Agrotis ypsilon exigua. Mating disruption may be possible given the success observed for Sporoptera exigua, in which 9-12 tetradecadienyl acetate released at higher concentration caused mating disruption in tomato, lucerne, and cotton fields. Volicitin. Volicitin, that is N17 hydroxylinolenoyl L-glutamine, isolated from oral secretions of Sporoptera exigua larvae. When applied to the damaged leaves of maize seedlings, volicitin induced the seedlings to emit volatile compounds that attracted females of the parasitoid Cortesia marginiventris. Mechanical damage of the leaves without application of this compound did not trigger the release of the same blend of volatiles. Volicitin appears to regulate tritropic interactions among the plants, insect, and herbivores, and the natural enemies of Sporoptera exigua. Now, the biological control. A large number of parasitic Hymenoptera acting as larval parasitoids have been reared from Sporoptera frugiparda, and many predators are recorded. It appears that natural controls are of considerable importance. Natural levels of larval parasitism are often very high, 20-70%, mostly by braconid wasps. Some 10-15% of larvae are often killed by pathogens. The natural enemies which are used or they can manage the Sporoptera frugiparda: first, wasp parasitoids like Cortesia marginiventris and Chelonis texanus. Fly parasitoids, Archidas marmoratus. The predators like various ground beetles, striped earwig, then the spined soldier bug and insidious flower bug. The vertebrates such as birds, skunks, and rodents also consume the larvae and pupae readily. The bacterium used, Bacillus thuringiensis, the virus, that is Podoptera frugiperda, nuclear polyhydrosis virus, the fungi, Entomophaga aulicae, Nomoria rilei, and Erinia radicans, the protozoans, which cause the nosema, and the nematodes. The parasitoid, Telenomus remus. Here you can see the egg mass from which the Telenomus remus is evolving. Then Trichogramma species, the structure that you see, the yellowish and reddish spots, that is the Trichogramma species. Then Potisia marginiventris, the larval pupal parasitoid, Architas marmoratus, this is a pupal parasitoid. Then Dioptimorpha introita, the striped earwig, Labidura riparia, the spined soldier bug, Podicus maculiventris, Aureus insidiosus, the skunks, all of you are familiar with this, Entomophaga aulicae, Nomoria rilei, these two, that is Entomophaga aulicae and Nomoria rilei, they are the fungal pathogens. Then the cocoons of larval parasitoid, that is Glypotapetalus creatonoti, the adult female of this wasp. Then the larval parasitoid, Campolytis chloridae, Ichneumonoid larval pupal parasitoid, these are all hymenopterans. On maize, if 5% of seedlings are cut or 20% of whorls of small plants, that is during the first 30 days, are infested, it is recommended that an insecticide be applied. This is, you can call it as the ETL. And on sorghum, based threshold level is regarded as 1 or 2 larvae per leaf whorl and 2 per head. Now about the use of insecticides, it should be the last resort to be taken up. In some areas, resistance to insecticides may be widespread and control can be difficult. Usually applied during the silking stage, it is often necessary to protect both the early vegetative stages and reproductive stage of corn. Because larvae feed deep in the whorl of young corn plants, a high volume of liquid insecticides may be required to obtain adequate penetration. The insecticides may be applied in irrigation water if it is applied from overhead sprinklers. Granular insecticides are also applied over the young plants because the particles fall deep into the whorl. Some resistance to insecticides has been noted, with resistance varying regionally. Foster in 1989 reported that keeping the plants free of larvae during the vegetative period reduced the number of sprays needed during the silking period. The Directorate of Plant Protection, Quarantine and Storage has issued a pest advisory in which the management practices for this fall armyworm have been recommended. The Central Integrated Pest Management Centers, that is CIPMCs, which are 35, through that these management strategies have been dispersed or advisories given. That is, first is egg parasitoids such as Trichogramma species and Telenomus remus can be released for destroying the egg stage of fall armyworm. After that, a very strict warning is also given to avoid the spraying of any chemical pesticide for a few days during the time of release in the field. Nuclear polyhydrosis virus should be used. The entomopathogenic fungi such as Nomoria rilei, Metarhizium anisopli may be extensively used for management of the pest. The following chemical pesticides such as dimethoate 30% EC and thimethoxam 12.6% plus lambda cyhalothrin 9.5% ZC, which is generally used against Lepidopteran pests of maize, may be applied for controlling fall armyworm. At last, we will see the general action plan for fall armyworm management. Strengthening surveillance, mobile application based fall armyworm pheromone trap surveillance system, and in Maharashtra we can see the CropSap. Monitoring and early warning systems. The fall armyworm monitoring and early warning system, FAMUS, which is implemented in the Africas. Awareness creation through mass communication materials and campaigns. Training and capacity development, implementation of community based IPM program and use of farmers field schools. investment in coordinated research on the pest, strengthened links and coordination between all academia, national organizations, etc. for more coordinated efforts, cross-border information sharing and issuing of pest alerts, and the impact assessment of all these things done. Protection and enhancing the indigenous natural enemies at a place, or classical biological control with imported beneficial organisms and biopesticides. And at last, we should have a restricted but appropriate chemical pesticide utilization. So these are all the things that are put forth about the fall armyworm and its management to avoid the losses to the humankind on this earth. Thank you.